Right there is Pat Tourbay on drums. Do you want to see him beat the shit out of those things again? Do it.
I've been dreaming about doing what I do since I was about 8 years old. And I'm one of the lucky ones that got to fulfill some of these dreams.
I made the first phone call to Eric, and we decided that we needed an amazing guitarist, and so I called Paul, and then we needed an amazing drummer too, so I called Pat.
The second we all heard Pat, we knew he was the guy.
Pat and I did the backing vocals that were later sampled and put on the David Lee Roth tour behind him for Skyscraper.
I love that kind of seed of inspiration, because stuff that, you know, when we're jamming, we're usually thinking what it's going to feel like in front of a big crowd. Are they going to be getting into it? So it's a good place to begin, as far as from my point of view. We're having a riot. We're in a room all together when we're playing, which is, some of the recording process is a little different than what we used to do. We're not so isolated from each other when we're playing. Now we're all in the same room. And I didn't know how it was going to work out, because this was different when we first did it. But now I want to do it like this all the time, because it's really, really captures the performance of the band, not the individuals playing in a band, but all four of us working together.
Even if a drummer isn't, say, as good as you are, or someone who's even just a beginner, you can find out something from them. You can learn something from them. I've never seen a drummer that every drummer has something that they do that you think, wow, I never thought of that. I mean, it always happens. It happens to me a million times. I got into drumming because I saw a guy playing drums in a polka band at a family picnic when I was about 8 years old. And I was mesmerized at just the whole movement of it. I was able to sit behind him and look down at the kit. And I was just smitten by the whole thing. And I went to my mother and I said, Mom, I want to play drums. And she thought, yeah, sure you do. And well, I bugged her for 3 years and she finally realized I wasn't going to give it up.
That we've gained by going on the road. When you go on the road, I mean, it's kind of a sink or swim situation, because you either end up breaking up or you get tighter. And if anything, we've gotten tighter. We're more, we know each other so much better. We're such a better band. So and I'm thriving on the dues paying, because we've been through a lot now. So it's like we're just building on that foundation of love and understanding.
Well, the message I would like to give to Mr. Big fans is, when you're in the tub, do not use a hairdryer.
So it's, you know, it may sound kind of corny and all that stuff, but there's so many people that tried to do this and didn't achieve it. And I just feel so fortunate and lucky thanks to all the fans, of course. I mean, couldn't have done it without you. And we're pledged to be better than ever, and hopefully we'll see you.